Hey everyone, I'm Haley. Welcome to Church at Home. We are in the middle of an awesome series learning all about what it means to be bold. When you're bold, you are confident and courageous. Because of what we believe about Jesus, we can be an example to others and share boldly about him. You ready for another way you can be bold for Jesus? Check out our big idea for today. It says, I can be bold and share God's promises. That is so important for us because sometimes we might wonder if we can really believe and trust a promise. And let me tell you, if God says it, it is true and you can trust it. He will always keep his promise. And what I love about this big idea is that you can be bold and do this no matter how old you are. Our Bible verse reminds us of that. Let's sing it out as we can remember these words. And maybe you can throw in some of your own bold dance moves too. Let's go. That verse reminds us to be an example to others in lots of different ways. So let's say that verse together. Listen up for the different ways we can be an example. Ready? Don't let anyone think less of you because you are young. Be an example to all believers in what you say, in the way you live, in your love, your faith, and your purity. 1 Timothy 4:12. We can be an example in the way we live, our love, our faith, and our purity. Basically, anything and everything you do shows others what you believe, and even more importantly, who you believe in. We can live boldly for Jesus with the things we say about him and about others, with the things we do to help and encourage people. That way, others will see how we live and may even choose to follow Jesus because of our example. Now, we're going to watch our Bible story all about someone who was bold enough to speak up and share God's promises. Check out this story from the Bible.
Stories of the Bible, Joshua and Caleb. This is Joshua.
Hiya.
And this is Caleb.
Hey!
Joshua and Caleb were some of the Israelites who followed Moses out of Egypt into the wilderness to find the land that God had promised them.
Yeah! Come on!
Sometime after that, God told Moses to send out men to explore the promised land, which was called the Land of Canaan. So Moses sent a leader from each of the 12 tribes of Israel, and Joshua and Caleb were among them. Moses told them to go see what the land was like and find out if the people living there were strong or weak. He told them to bring back a report of all they found.
Yeah, let's do it!
So the 12 men went and explored. While they were there, they found that the land was very good for crops.
Look at this!
They found a single cluster of grapes that took 2 men to carry.
That's good!
After 40 days, they returned to Moses and showed them the fruit they found. They said it was a land flowing with milk and honey, and that it was a good land. But they also said that the people living there were powerful, and that their cities were strong. They even saw giants there. But Caleb said, "Let's go at once to take the land. We can certainly conquer it."
Come on!
But the other men who were with him disagreed and spread the bad report all throughout the Israelite camp. This made the Israelites cry all through the night. They told Moses and Aaron that they wished they had died in Egypt or in the wilderness and asked for a new leader who would take them back to Egypt. Moses and Aaron fell face down on the ground. Joshua and Caleb tore their clothing. Joshua and Caleb told the people, "The land we traveled through and explored is a wonderful land. And if the Lord is pleased with us, he will bring us safely into the land and give it to us. Do not rebel against the Lord, and don't be afraid of the people of the land. They have no protection, but the Lord is with us. Don't be afraid of them." But all the Israelites talked about hurting Joshua and Caleb. Then God's presence appeared to the Israelites, and God spoke to Moses. He was very angry at the Israelites and said to Moses, "Will they never believe me, even after all the miraculous signs I have done among them?" God said that he would make a new nation for Moses and that the Israelites would be no more. But Moses asked God to forgive the people, and God said he would, but that the people would wander in the wilderness for 40 years and none of the people would enter the promised land except for Joshua and Caleb. The people did wander for 40 years. Moses died and Joshua became the new leader of the Israelites. Time came for Joshua to lead the Israelites into the promised land that Joshua and Caleb had scouted many years before. Joshua led the people, including Caleb, into the promised land, for God was with him wherever he went.
I kind of get why the 10 spies responded the way they did. It might have felt scary to think about taking over a new land full of new things, even giants. But I love how Caleb reminded them of God's promise to give them the land. You see, God had already promised that land to the Israelites. So when others focused on the bad and the scary, Caleb chose to be bold and speak up. He focused on God's promise. And when things feel scary in your life, you can remember the promises God has for you. Promises to love you forever, always keep you safe, always comfort you, and so many more. And you can be bold when you speak up and remind yourself and others of those promises. Speaking of bold, I think it's time to check out a bold new collab show where our friends Greg and Jerry are discovering what it means to be bold as they review some of the best. Check it out.
What's up, everyone, and welcome to Be Bold, a new collab show where we are continuing my tradition of reviewing some of the best, but this time, I'm not alone.
Jerry!
Greg!
Whoa! Oh! Hey, everybody! I'm Greg the Adventure Guy, and Jerry's been so nice to have me on his show, where he's gonna pick something new for me to test out as part of his review.
That's right, the biggest, boldest, most awesome toys and gadgets. Being bold is all about being courageous and confident, and no one is more courageous and confident than my buddy, Greg. This is
Greg and Jerry Be Bold!
Last week, we were in the studio the whole time, but Greg is itching for an adventure. So today, he's gonna head back out into the field. Greg, you ready?
I think so, Jerry. Whoa, this thing's awesome.
Today, we're gonna be reviewing this state-of-the-art motor scooter, but before we get started, you wanna tell us a little bit more about it?
Oh yeah, you know it. This is the Subblue Underwater Dual Motor Scooter. It's fully waterproof up to 131 feet and powerful enough to pull multiple people.
Whoa, that sounds pretty impressive. But to make sure that we give this underwater scooter a proper review, I've set up an underwater treasure hunt. And I'm gonna be monitoring this live stream from here inside the studio, but it's gonna be up to Greg. So he's gonna be talking with me in real time and he's gotta bring that treasure back to us. You ready to go?
Oh yeah, let's do it, Jerry. Wait, where are we going?
Well, you're gonna have to wait and see.
Okay, whoa, Jerry! Whoa, this thing's more powerful than I thought!
There's pirate treasure hidden below the depths of this pool. Greg's job is gonna be to ride the underwater scooter around until he finds all of it. We'll let you get comfortable with that scooter before we send you fully underwater.
Sounds good, Jerry. I think I can do it. Don't electrocute me, Scooter. Ugh, I've never used one of these contraptions before, so we're really gonna have to put it to the test. Okay, we're powered up here. Whoa, we got some spray in there. It looks like it's gonna work. All right, I'm getting my goggles. We're going under.
Whoa, that looks so awesome. Nice, Greg, good job getting that one. Whew. That thing is so fast. You see the thrust on this scooter? Ooh, this thing can take turns real tight. Oh, and another piece. Good job, Greg. This underwater scooter's amazing. Look at this image quality. Wow, you can really see everything. Whoa, guys, do you see what I'm seeing? Greg, get that one. You got it, you're so close. Oh yeah, good job. Oh, Greg, you just found two pieces. Good job. Oh, you got this, Greg, I believe in you. Nice, Greg. Good job getting that one.
Okay, Jerry. So, change of plans.
How high up
we had to get to the top of the pirate ship to actually see the last piece of treasure down there at the bottom. And I think I got a visual of it. Oh. The only way down is this trusty hatch right here.
You gotta
get jumping.
You got this, Greg.
So here we go.
Here we go.
Count of three.
One.
One.
Two.
Three.
Go, Greg! Oh, he's underwater. Oh, Greg. Greg? Greg! Oh, he's okay. He's okay, guys. And he's got the last piece of the treasure! Good job! Go ahead and bring that piece back to the studio, and we'll see you soon, Greg.
Whoa! That scooter is no joke! I felt like I was exploring an underwater world or something. It was so much fun. I mean, I definitely had my hesitations at first, but when you reminded me of the promise that the scooter would go over 131 feet underwater, I was ready to go. All I had to do was focus on the positive and less on being scared.
Sometimes we all just need a little reminder of the good so we aren't so afraid of the bad. Like, remember in that Bible story from today when Joshua and Caleb were scouting out that promised land?
Oh yeah, I mean, they saw some wild stuff, like giant grapes that people had to carry on their shoulders and literal giants. I would be pretty freaked out.
Yeah, me too, but instead of focusing on the bad, I love how Caleb confidently reminded everyone that God had promised that land to them.
Because of what he believed about God, he wasn't afraid.
Caleb was bold and had confidence to take that land because he knew it was for them from God. He knew that God would keep his promise no matter what, no matter how scary or impossible things may seem, nothing is impossible for God, and God will always keep his promise.
Totally. Now, even though Joshua and Caleb saw all the same things as the other scouts, because they remembered God's promise, they came to a totally different conclusion. They chose to trust God. And that gave them some serious confidence.
And guess what? You know, God did give them that land just like he promised. There are so many stories like that in the Bible that prove to us God always keeps his promises. He might not have promised land to us, but he does have promises just for us.
That's right. God tells us that he'll love us forever and that he'll always be with us.
Oh yeah, he promises us comfort when things are hard or scary.
God promises to keep us safe.
And God's promises are for everyone who believe in Jesus and belong in his family.
So we can trust God no matter what's going on in our lives.
Exactly. Even when we're afraid, God always makes good on his promises. And if we can remember those promises, we can be bold and live courageously.
Maybe there's someone you know who has lost confidence or is afraid. Now, is there a promise from God that they need to be reminded of? Maybe you can be bold and be the one to share about God's love for them, to help give them the confidence that they need.
Yeah, that's so good. We can be people that share the truth about God and his promises with others. Friends, thanks for watching us get into some more hijinks this week. We've got one more episode of Be Bold left, and it's going to be a lot of fun.
Oh yeah, you don't want to miss it next week.
No, you do not. We'll see you then.
Bye!
At first, Greg wasn't feeling too confident, was he? He was nervous to get in the water on that scooter. But when Jerry reminded him of the promise from the people that made it, that the scooter was in fact made to go in the water, Greg was a little more bold and confident and boldly went into the water. Here's the thing, when you hear something good like these promises from God we've been talking about, you'll want to share it. And God's promises are good, so we can be bold and share them. Maybe you don't know what some of the promises are. No problem. There are people at church and people in your life who love Jesus that would be happy to share these promises with you. Because when people believe in Jesus, God gives them a helper, the Holy Spirit, who gives us power and helps us be bold. I'm so glad you joined me for church at home today. We'd love to see you in person at church too. Check out our campus locations and find a Saddleback Kids near you. Don't forget, we have some awesome activity sheets, coloring pages, and even some stuff for your parents online at saddlebackkids.com. Check it out, and we'll see you here next week. Bye.